Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. So today we are going to discuss on analysis of induction motor fed from non-sinusoidal supply voltage. So this non-sinusoidal voltage supply is usually used when we need a speed control. Okay, so a speed control of a induction motor is possible by various methods, but as far as our knowledge is considered, we know that variable frequency drives are used in industries for controlling the speed of a induction motor. So we go for V by F control, and varying the frequency of a sinusoidal supply is possible only by rectifying it and then feeding it through a inverter. So now these inverters will give us a pulsed square waves. This is one of the ancient techniques where we get a square pulse waves. We call this as a pulse width modulation technique. So when we get a square pulse width or sinusoidal pulse width modulation, the output of the inverter is nothing but a square wave, which is not sinusoidal. So now we are going to study the effect of feeding these square pulses or the non-sinusoidal waveforms to the stator of the induction motor, how it is going to affect the performance. So that we are going to analyze. So non-sinusoidal waveform can be analyzed as a fundamental sinusoidal wave and a smaller sine waves, which are called as its harmonics. So any signal, any random signal or any random waveform can be expressed as a component containing a majority of its factor, which is called as a fundamental, and subcomponents, which is smaller and smaller and smaller sine waves with higher and higher and higher frequency. So the addition of these smaller sine waves, which are called as harmonics in electrical term, to the fundamental gives us this original signal. So these original square pulses which we have, so we divide it into fundamental component and harmonic components. So the analysis what we use for this purpose is done with the help of Fourier analysis. So basically it means that any square wave can be represented as summation of different sine waves, where one is fundamental, remaining waves are called as harmonics. So in our electrical engineering, only odd harmonics are present, odd order, that is 3rd, 5th, 7th, 9th and so on. Even harmonics are not present, because in our signals and system, if we have studied, we know there is something called as a half wave symmetry. Now the fundamental wave, the inner half cycle of a fundamental wave, all the even harmonics will have 2, 4, 6, 8 half cycles. So if I consider a second harmonic, so in the half cycle of a fundamental harmonic, a second harmonic will have 2 half cycles, one positive half cycle and one negative half cycle. So when the positive half cycle of the fundamental is completed, the effect of the second harmonic is neutralized. That is, the average value of second harmonic will become zero. Similarly, it is also true in the case of fourth, sixth and all even order harmonics. Because of their half cycle symmetry, their average value will be zero. But that is not the case when we speak about odd harmonics. So we are going to study about the effect of the presence of these odd harmonics along with the fundamental when we are feeding a induction motor from a non-sinusoidal supply. So now these harmonics of different orders which are present can be resolved into positive sequence, negative sequence and zero sequence. Because now we know what is a positive sequence, that is, If any set of voltages whose phase sequence is same as that of fundamental, we call it as a positive sequence. If their phase sequence is opposite to that of the fundamental, we call it as a negative sequence. And when all three are in phase, we call it as a zero sequence. So this is our concern now, how to represent any harmonic into positive, negative and zero sequence, so that it will be easier for us to analyze. So harmonics with the phase sequence same as that of fundamental are called as positive sequence. Harmonics with the phase sequence opposite of that of fundamental are called as negative sequence. And harmonics with all three phases in phase are called zero sequence components. So this is how we are going to categorize. So now fundamental phase voltages that is given to a stator of a induction motor, three phase induction motor, its phase voltages are expressed as shown. So the expression given are VAN, that is the A phase voltage with respect to neutral, if it is represented by V1 sin omega t, where 1 stands for fundamental, omega stands for its frequency, then VBN will be represented as V1 sin omega t minus 2 pi by 3, that is VBN lags VAN by 120 degree. VCN is equal to V1 sin omega t minus 4 pi by 3, that is VCN lags VBN by 120 degree further. So this is a three phase voltages, nothing special about it, it is the called as a fundamental voltage. This will be our reference. Now the sequence ABC which we are following here is called as a positive sequence. Okay, so that is A is a reference, B is lagging by 120, C is lagging B by 120 and leading A by 120, or lagging A by 240 degrees. So these are our basic principles. So this is a basic equation which we have. Now with the help of these equations, we have to write corresponding fifth and seventh harmonic. So let us be very clear about harmonics first. Any order harmonic, okay, its magnitude reduces compared to the fundamental, but frequency increases. And theoretically, a fifth order harmonic's magnitude will be 1 by 5th of fundamental, and fifth order harmonic's frequency will be 5 times that of fundamental. Similarly, seventh order harmonic's magnitude will be 1 by 7th of fundamental, and 7th order harmonics frequency will be 7 times that of fundamental. So now I am using the same notation VAN, VB and CN to find out the 5th harmonic components, and instead of writing the fractional magnitudes, I am representing with the respective suffix numbers. So V5 indicates that it is the magnitude of a fifth harmonic voltage. Its frequency, since it is a fifth harmonic, its frequency should be 5 times the fundamental. So VAN is equal to V5 sin phi omega t. Next, VBN. So now it should be V5 sin, its frequency is 5 times the fundamental, but VBN lags VAN by 120 degree. So the terms inside the bracket are retained as follows, that is omega t and 2 pi by 3. So this particular term which is shown here is retained as it is, and the whole term inside the bracket is fifth order frequency. Now when we open the brackets, this phi omega t times phi into minus 2 pi by 3. Okay, so phi into minus 2 pi by 3 should be minus 10 pi by 3, but here we have got it as minus 4 pi by 3. So how is that possible? That we have to see. So this is by the property of a sinusoidal waveform, that every sine wave instance repeats for every 2 pi radians. That is, for every 360 degree, the value of symmetrical sine wave will be same. Okay, it means that if you know what is sine 90, that is 1, then sine 90 plus 360 will be 1. Sine 90 plus 360 into 2, that is sine 90 plus 720 will be 1. And sine 90 plus 360 into 3, that also will be 1. So now we want all the phase differences in terms of 120 and 240. Okay, that is lagging by 120 degree and lagging by 240 degrees for our easier analysis. So using that sine 2 pi plus theta property, what we are doing is we are adding 360 degree to the existing values. So what we had minus 120. Okay, we had minus 120 degrees. We multiplied it by 5. So when we multiply 120 degrees by 5, what do we get? We get 600 degrees, that is minus 600 degrees. So now I said earlier that we want either 120 or either 240 degrees inside the brackets in order to eliminate that 360 possibility. So I will add 360 degree to this. Okay, so I'll add 360 degree to minus 600. What I'll get is minus 240 degree. Okay, so I'm adding 360, so I'm getting minus 240 degree, which is nothing but minus 4 pi by 3. So this is the phase B of fifth harmonic, which is lagging phase A by 240, whereas the fundamental lags by 120. Okay, similarly phase C of fifth harmonic will be given by V phi sine phi omega t minus 4 pi by 3, which is the term which is given here. That is given here. Let us open the brackets now. Now, similarly, we multiply the minus 240, which is here. Okay, we have minus 240 inside the brackets. We are multiplying it by 5. Okay, so what do we get? 1200, that is minus 1200 degrees. So now what we have to do, we have to go on adding 360 degrees. So try this with the help of a calculator. Go on adding 360 degree till you get 240 or 120. So if you observe carefully using a calculator, what is the best thing what we get here is minus 120 degrees, which is written by minus 2 pi by 3. Okay, so here if you observe that fifth harmonic A, B and C are negative phase sequence compared to that of the fundamental. Now let us see what happens to the seventh harmonic. So V7 sin 7 omega t, similarly VBN 7 times. Okay, the same exercise I am supposed to do here. Open the brackets, multiply 120 by 7 and go on adding 360 till I get 120 or 240. So I repeat the exercise. I get this as the equation. Please try this in the calculator so that you can remember the equations very quickly. Okay, now here we observe that it is 0, 120 and 240, same like that of the fundamental. So the seventh harmonic components are in phase with the fundamental. So if we call fundamental as the positive sequence, then fifth harmonic we can call it as a negative sequence, and seventh harmonic we can call it as a positive sequence components. So from these equations, the conclusion is fifth harmonic components are negative sequence components and seventh harmonic components are positive sequence components. So now there arises a question, why we are considering fifth and seventh, why not second, third, fourth, sixth? So as mentioned in the earlier, even harmonics are eliminated automatically. Okay, even harmonics are eliminated automatically. Now we know something called as a triple N harmonics. Okay, if we substitute 3 and so on, what we get is we do not get any sequence component, we get zero sequence. Okay, kindly try it out. So harmonic voltages and currents of order M is equal to 6k plus 1, okay, where k is an integer starting from 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, if it is of the order 6k plus 1, then all those are positive sequence component. So if we substitute k is equal to 1 here, what we get is m is equal to 7. So 7th harmonic is positive sequence. Next, what we have to substitute? We have to substitute k is equal to 2. So 12 plus 1, 13th harmonic. 13th harmonic is a positive sequence, and so on. Next is the harmonics of the order m is equal to 6k minus 1 are negative sequence component. Okay, so if we substitute k is equal to 1, we get 6 minus 1, 5. So fifth harmonic component is a negative sequence component. And similarly, if I substitute k is equal to 2, it is 11th harmonic component is a negative sequence component. Now harmonics of the order m is equal to 3k. Harmonics of the order m is equal to 3k, we call it as a zero sequence component. If you want, you can substitute 3 here instead of 5 and verify it yourself in the calculators. We get that VAN, VB and VCN will be in phase, and you can repeat the exercise for different values. So if we substitute k is equal to 2, we get 6, and k is equal to 3, we get 3. So all the multiples of 3, that is triple N, okay, we call triple N harmonics, they are all zero sequence components. Now, mth order positive sequence component, okay, any positive sequence component, okay, in general, will produce a rotating field. Okay, whether it is a voltage or current, it will produce a rotating field in the direction of fundamental, because fundamental is positive sequence, correct? So a harmonic which is positive sequence will also produce a magnetic field in the same direction which the fundamental was producing. But the speed of this magnetic field will be m times the fundamental. So now we know that seventh harmonic is a positive sequence component. So seventh harmonic will produce a positive sequence field. But the speed at which this rotating magnetic field revolves, okay, or rotates, will be 7 times the synchronous speed, because fundamental will always rotate at synchronous speed. So if the synchronous speed of the motor is 1500 rpm, then the fundamental rotating magnetic field will rotate at 1500 rpm, and the field produced by 7th harmonic will rotate in the same direction at a speed of 7 into 1500 rpm. Okay, so any positive sequence harmonic will produce the field rotating in the same direction whose speed is m times that of fundamental. Next point, any mth order harmonic which is negative sequence will produce the field in opposite direction, and its speed will also be m times. Okay, so in general, any mth order harmonic will produce a rotating magnetic field whose speed is m times the synchronous speed or the fundamental. And if it is positive sequence, its direction will be same that of fundamental. If it is negative sequence, its direction will be reverse or negative compared to the fundamental. Now, zero sequence components do not produce any rotating magnetic field. Okay, because to produce a rotating magnetic field, we need a phase difference of 120 degree. And in zero sequence components, there is no phase difference. So zero sequence components do not produce any rotating magnetic field. Okay, they may produce a small magnetic field, but it is not called as RMF. Okay, so these zero sequence components do not produce any rotating magnetic field. So now we have seen the equivalent circuit of an induction motor in the first part, that is the analysis, okay, where we studied about the analysis of the induction motor at the beginning of this module. There we have seen the equivalent circuit of an induction motor and have derived torque equation, and also we have found out what is the equation for the rotor current. Now the same circuit is analogous here, okay, but instead we see the term M several times here. This is a harmonic equivalent circuit of a induction motor. For the time being, focus on figure A. Okay, for the time being, focus only on figure A. Each reactance, okay, so we have stator reactance and we also have rotor reactance per phase, okay, will increase by a factor M. Now if we are considering the effect of harmonic voltage alone, okay, let us say we are studying fifth harmonic now. So we are using the same equivalent circuit and studying the effect of that fifth harmonic only. So then each reactance will increase by a factor M. So if we are studying fifth harmonic, then each reactance will increase by a factor 5. Okay, if you are studying seventh harmonic, then each reactance will increase by a factor 7. Resistance also increases several times due to skin effect, because we know that now the frequency of the fundamental increases. If the frequency increases due to the magnetic interaction, the current will tend to flow only on the surface of the conductor and not beneath, skin effect. And as the frequency of supply voltage is more and more, skin effect will also be more. So this gives to a rise of a fictitious resistance. Okay, now by what factor this resistance increases, that is not mentioned. For reactance, we can say that it is directly dependent on frequency. So we can say that reactance increases by a factor M. But here, resistance increases several times. So these resistance are denoted by a separate term, RSM. Okay, this is a suffix. This is not a multiplier. In the case of resistance, it is not a multiplier. It is just a suffix. Whereas in case of reactance, it is a multiplier. Okay. So now, for any mth order harmonic, the slip is given by, the equation is same, synchronous minus rotor speed divided by synchronous. But here, for mth harmonic, synchronous speed itself is m times fundamental. Okay. Now this minus or plus, what is this minus or plus? Why not plus or minus? The natural equation is omega ms minus omega m. Okay. And that we have retained here. So when fed from a semiconductor converter, these harmonic torques, okay, these are close to zero, because now suppose we have a field, newly generated field, rotating in the same direction, then we use a negative symbol here. If we have a field rotating in opposite direction, we use a positive signal. And as this value of M goes on increasing, the value of SM will be almost equal to 1. Okay, so when this is almost equal to 1, the effect of torques is 0, because when a slip is unity, there will not be any torque produced. That is, when the rotor speed will be equal to the synchronous speed, there will not be any torque produced. So we are speaking only about a harmonic torque. It doesn't mean that motor will stop here, okay? The torques, harmonic torque will be close to zero. Why we are speaking about semiconductor device now? Because these semiconductor devices will have its own rise time and fall time, which will also have its own inductance and capacitance, which will act like a low pass filters. Okay, so this fundamental torque and fundamental rotor current value, okay, it is calculated from the original equations only, which we have discussed in the analysis part in the beginning of this module. The same torque equation and rotor current equation hold good for fundamental value. Now, whereas for mth harmonic, the current value is calculated from this particular circuit. Now what happens, as the harmonic value goes on increasing, the reactance becomes higher and high, and when compared to the value of reactance, these resistance become negligible. Okay, these resistance become negligible, and thus since these circuits are in parallel, we can skip this inductance, that is magnetizing inductance, and here we obtain at this equivalent circuit which is shown, and thus we get mth order harmonic current from this particular circuit by using KVL. Okay, so the equation is Im is equal to Vm by Mx, where M stands for the number of harmonic. So the supply voltage and supply current of that particular harmonic, and X is synchronous reactance, which we call as stator reactance plus rotor reactance referred to the stator side. Okay, per phase. So the all these are per phase values. So now when the stator is connected in star, triple N harmonics will not flow. Okay, that is the third order harmonics will not flow. Then the RMS value is given by the equation shown here. So we can see that in the place of M we have 5, 7, 6 is not there because it is a triple N harmonic. 9 is not there, 11, 13, 15 will not be there, 17, 19, 21 will not be there, and so on. Okay, triple N harmonics will be removed. But when the stator is connected in delta, these triple N harmonics will circulate in the stator winding but will not reflect in the, so the RMS current equation will be, these will include 3, 6 is not there because 6 is a even harmonic. Okay, only odd level harmonics will be present, so 6 is not there. So 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15 will be there, then 17, 19, 21 will also be there because it is delta connection. So this find the RMS value of the supply current when the harmonics are present. Okay, the harmonics will be present when the supply voltage is non-sinusoidal. So that is our analysis. So presence of these harmonics will lead to a higher value of current, because we know that instead of just being the fundamental value of the RMS current, the fundamental value will gets added by the respective harmonic currents when harmonics are present. Thus, the when these harmonics are present, due to the skin effect, resistance will also increase. So we know what is a copper loss. Copper loss is given by I square R. Now I is also increasing, R is also increasing. This will substantially increase the copper loss. Now these harmonic currents or voltages will have higher frequency, and whenever frequency is high, core loss, that is iron loss, which is a frequency dependent, eddy current and hysteresis loss, which is dependent on frequency, this will also become high. So along with the copper loss, core loss will also increase. Now what happens when the current is high? Okay, the temperature rise increases, that is when we are going to overload the motor, it actually draws more number amount of current than the calculated one. Thus what happens, it the permissible temperature rise will reach very early before the motor is actually operating in the rated power. Temperature rise will be very early, and if we have temperature sensing relays, trip the motor before it is fully loaded. So in such cases the motor has to be derated, that is it has to be operated at a lower power than which is actually designed. The motor has to be derated. So because of this, the overall efficiency of the motor also decreases. So this non-sinusoidal supply will produce sitting torques. Okay, so what are these pulsating torques? Now we have different fields induced in the air gap of different levels of harmonics. Okay, where the dominant harmonics are 5th, 7th, 11th and 13th. Now what happens? These four harmonics will have four fields. So 4 into 4, 16 combinations are possible. That is each current acting with the different field. And whenever current interacts with the field, it produces a torque. That is the definition of the torque, and these torques, 16 torques, are called as pulsating torques. These are present on sinusoidal supplies used. Fifth harmonic component produces a rotating field backward direction, because fundamental direction we always consider as forward. Okay, so this is the very first model we have used these produce. Phase sequence we have proved it also. Okay. Fundamental is forward. Pulsating torque which is produced by of the fundamental. Okay. Frequency of the fundamental, a pulsating torque is produced. Similarly, the 11th and 13th. So when the supply effective if the sub okay, that is we using a variable frequency drive, we usually start it at a lower frequency. Then in such cases these pulsating torques create problems because they cause pulsation which is not compensated by the inertia, and thus will lead towards motion. So this is the analysis induction motor running on non-sinusoidal supply. So please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon. So that's all we have got for today. Thank you.